For those who still aren't sure about Logan, here's someone who may win you over. He knows the airport inside out.
A perspective he shares in his ode to Logan.
I've been an airline geek, for lack of a better term, my whole life.
Patrick Smith boarded an airplane for the first time in 1974. Today, he is a first officer with a major airline, an author, and a popular blogger on all things air travel. He grew up in Revere, in the path of planes on their final approach to Logan.
For all of the changes at Logan that have been positive, the big negative to me, and this is looking at it sentimentally, is the closure of the 16th floor observation deck, where you could see the airport on one side, the city on the other side. I remember being there when the Pope came to Boston and seeing him ride past in his motorcade in the rain on a knoll between Terminal C and E. You know, kids and their families from East Boston and from downtown and the suburbs would come just to hang out and just watch planes. The idea of the airport as a leisure destination just doesn't exist anymore. I've been to airports all over the world, and I happen to think that Logan is one of the more underrated airports. And I don't know why. I mean, it's attractive, it's easy to get around, easy to navigate, a free public transportation link to downtown. Lots of airports that score higher don't have these things. In my plane spotting days in the 70s and 80s, you had a token number of flights every night to Western Europe. It's a global airport in a way that really would have been unimaginable. How is that not cool? The fact that you can get on an airplane there and fly to so many points all across the globe. My first flight as a commercial pilot was flying into Logan. What a feeling that was to see the airport from that perspective. Logan's Tower, you can call it an ugly building, but there's no denying that it's iconic. One of the very few airport buildings anywhere in the world that is a signature in that when you see it, you know exactly where you are. It's part of the Boston skyline, and there aren't any airport buildings that you can say that same thing of except for this one. Well, this might come across as a little overly enthusiastic or even obsessive, but sometimes when I'm at Logan as a traveler, I'll go early and just walk around, retracing, you know, my footsteps from when I was a kid and just observing the ways in which the airport has changed and the ways in which it's the same. It's hard for me not to have a love for Logan. Whether I'm flying as a passenger or as a pilot, it's always on some level special.
Love it or hate it, still ours. I happen to be in the love category. I always love Logan.
I love it too. That is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Shayna Seymour.
And I'm Anthony Everett. Have a great evening. See you tomorrow night.